I have felt betrayed recently by someone I looked to as a guide in my own transformation. And I realize the reason I feel betrayed is because they switched sides. And I want to talk about that today. I'm Trista Polo. I woke up this way and it's awesome. It's a new day, it's a new year, and it's a new me. If you've never been to my channel before, welcome. I cover topics relating to self-love, self-care, and authenticity as you are reaching for your goals and dreams. I believe that everyone deserves to succeed and win, whatever that looks like for you. And I explore topics around spiritual transformation, law of attraction, guides, angels, and the like. I wasn't indoctrinated into a specific religious belief when I was growing up. So I was given the opportunity to explore my own beliefs. The path that I have followed has led me to law of attraction, spirituality, and exploring who I am and how I can guide my own reality, choices, and beliefs through meditation and transformation. Now, one of the people that helped me along in the beginning was a woman named Doreen Virtue. She was an angel card reader, a psychic, and she was very involved in the Hay House family of publishers. And of all of the decks that I've enjoyed exploring to look for guidance and see what my inner knowing is telling me, this has always been my favorite. We have spent a lot of time together. I had the opportunity to see her speak once at a Hay House event. I thought she was a little odd, but I embraced her willingness to be her authentic self, no matter what others believed, because she had a true north that came from inside of her. It gave me the courage to do the same. I even took an angel card reading course from her a couple of years ago. A few months ago, I was out looking for a new deck that I had read about. And while I was there, I wanted to see what new angel card decks she had come out with. And I was told by the store that they have removed every item that she published and were not going to sell them anymore. I thought this was pretty odd. Nobody who worked there seemed to know why, but I sort of forgot about it. There's an article that's being shared a lot right now, and it's a pretty intriguing topic. It's called an A to Z list of New Age practices to avoid and why. On that list is everything I have always known her to promote. Spirits, angels, angel card reading, psychic abilities, law of attraction, energy healing, Reiki energy. What? I don't understand. When I first read this article, I thought it was a dummy site that was made to look like hers. Then I realized it was really her site. I thought she had been hacked. And then I read the article that probably caused that store to stop carrying any of her stuff. See, about a year and a half ago, she had a vision, and that vision changed everything for her. She went from being a New Age spiritual practitioner, teacher, coach, trainer, to being a Christ and Christian advocate and damning all that aren't. I'm not gonna lie, it rocked me to the core. When I meditate, thoughts about it creep in. When I ask my inner knowing for guidance, which I call my angels and guides, thoughts of demons creep in. When I declare myself to be someone who's deserving of unconditional love, who's a powerful being that deserves success, the words from her blog that is blasphemous creep in. So I've been struggling with it, and I've come to a sort of truce with her and myself. See, she has the right to declare herself to be whomever she says. She gets to believe that there are demons and that energy is bad and that creating on this planet is anti-God. And if I believe that we all get to win whatever we say that looks like to us, who am I to say that she's wrong because her beliefs question mine? I have a lot of cards of Doreen's. She has requested that her name be removed from all products associated with New Age and spiritual beliefs. Hay House has honored her request. The store where I was has honored her request, so I'm going to honor her request as well. Starting with my favorite deck, it is no longer a Doreen Virtue product. And the decks that were written by Doreen, I'm removing her name from those too. This is a great lesson for me to learn. Acceptance, generosity, and unconditional love for those that believe differently from me. For those that say that my beliefs are wrong. Are you strong enough to unconditionally love those who disagree with you? I'm still a work in progress, but I figure the songs are right and the poems are true. Love conquers all. So I love you, Doreen Virtue. I love who you are in the world. But more importantly, I love myself and who I am in the world. And I declare that both of us, while differing in opinion and differing in truth, are right. Because I get to say so, and so do you. For the Doreen Virtue fans and followers out there, what was your reaction to her article? You can put any comment you want on this video. I won't censor it, because we all deserve our truth. So share it with me now. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. I'm Trista Polo. I woke up this way. It is my truth, and it is awesome. Have a great day, everybody.